the Dullamys Cave. Music is about the importance of being filled with the Spirit, singing psalms and hymns, and also spiritual songs, as Paul tells us in the letter to the Ephesians. And we've been singing psalms about Zion and emphasizing how important it is that through the psalms and the singing of the psalms, we're brought back to a very powerful biblical theme of Zion that should be part of our regular praise. We've sung hymns about Zion, and I'm going today and tomorrow to just launch out into singing what I understand to be spiritual songs. Once the Word of God has been imparted to us through preaching or through reading and goes into our minds and hearts, spiritual song is where we trust the Holy Spirit to reflect back again to our Heavenly Father and to the Lord Jesus what we have learnt and what we've come to appreciate about them. And it's something that, again, I believe should be a regular part of our own worship individually. We don't have to be good singers or even musical to be able to do it, because usually nobody else will be listening apart from the Lord and the angels and perhaps even the saints in heaven. But in a corporate setting, it could be an individual who's really inspired to sing out under the grace of the Holy Spirit. And it's more liable to happen in a corporate setting when individual Christians are making a part of their own personal worship. And so that's my offering in a Dullamys post, Dullamys Music post today. Eternal God, Triune God, three persons in one being, enthroned in worship by angels and saints in glory, through your beloved Son, our Savior Christ, I approach your throne of grace. With my great high priest sat down at your right hand, O Father, in him, through him, I come into your presence. I worship you in Zion, the city of the Lord, and bring my offering of praise and thanksgiving to you. Worthy are you, Lord, worthy are to receive glory, honor, power, and dominion. I worship you in the glory of your perfections, your eternal being, your infinite perfection, in all of your attributes, wisdom, truth, and power, and above all else, your amazing grace and love for your people whom you have drawn in.
you.